then you just come.
Oh, no.
Well, don't do it then.
No. This is the last straw.
Oh, come on.
No.
Videoing.
Mm.
I think he's happy that he got him a fairy.
So do I.
He gone in there, look.
Oh no! Oh, he looks over. Even if it is his last days, at least he'll have someone there.
And so much now we couldn't, you couldn't physically do a panel downstairs anymore. But Father Tom's absolutely brilliant, and we had a little table. I've been pushing for a table for quite a while, so we had a little table, and it was great. A guy called Lee, which I think his surname's Hawker, he came up with some of the 501st and said that he just discovered our podcast in January. So I had a great little chat with Lee about Pussable, because he'd been there and showing us some photographs of when he'd been there in his stormtrooper costume. But plenty of other people know, like Neil from the Isle of Wight, whose surname.
And the next question comes to us from Lee Hawker, who writes, my question for you is this. With John Williams already confirming that he will be scoring Indiana Jones 5, due to be released in 2020, doesn't this pretty much guarantee that he'll also score Star Wars Episode 9 that isn't due out until the year before? Well, thanks a lot for the question, Lee. And yeah, I mean, John Williams himself said at his concert at the Hollywood Bowl, not this weekend, but like 2 years ago, that he's been contacted, he's going to be doing the score for another Indiana Jones movie. We already know that Steven Spielberg said they're doing it. They still haven't hammered down when. There was a recent interview with the screenwriter for the new Indiana Jones movie, and they said he's not really sure when they're going to shoot it. They're hoping it'll be Steven Spielberg's next film, but they didn't know for sure if it was going to be the next film that Spielberg directs or not. Harrison Ford isn't getting any younger. Will John Williams score it? Maybe. He's 85. At some point, he's going to retire. But if he does actually score Indiana Jones, and Star Wars Episode 9 comes out the year before, I still don't know that that guarantees John Williams will score it. Remember, they just did a Star Wars movie that didn't have John Williams scoring it. He is getting to the age now that he's going to want to be more picky and choosy about how much work he wants to take on. And remember this, too. Really, they like to leave it up to the directors as to which composer they want to work with. Doesn't always happen, but for the most part, it's up to the directors. Remember, John Williams told the story this weekend at his concert, where he said it was Ryan Johnson who reached out to John Williams and said, will you score this film, Star Wars Episode 8? To which he said, of course I will. But it was Ryan Johnson. If Ryan Johnson wanted to use a different composer, I think that Lucasfilm probably would have let, because the composer and the director have to work so closely together in, you know, coming up the feel and the tone and the way the music's going to work with the film. I mean, it's the composer that does all the composing, but they've got to come up with things that the director likes and understands and wants, and they have to have a great communication between them. If Ryan Johnson had wanted a different composer, like say he wanted Alan Silvestri, or maybe he wanted Michael Giacchino, or maybe he wanted Danny Elfman, or maybe he wanted Zimmer, or maybe whatever. If he wanted a different composer, they probably would have let him have a different composer. But they let him go with John Williams, so partially it's going to be up to the director. Look, long story short, even if he is doing Raiders of the Lost Ark, I don't think it guarantees he'll do Episode 9. I would put my money on it, but it doesn't guarantee it. All right, we move on now, guys, to the final question.